All right, so where do we get this expression for angular size, and where does this number come from? So it's easiest if we think about it as sort of like ratios, and think about a circle. Because when we're looking at something that has a particular size, say maybe from here to here in the sky, then this right here is the angle that it covers. And so this right here is the angular size. Now, this right here would be this distance, would be the actual size, because this is, you know, if this would be the object we're looking at. And then finally, this would represent the distance. And so the angular size and the actual size and the distance and the 57.3 come from comparing literally like this little piece of the pie that we've just sort of outlined in red, and we've talked about all these different shapes. And then if we think about going the whole way around the circle. And so let's sort of compare, in a way we're comparing the angle to the distance around. So for instance, if we have a whole circle, if we go the whole way around the circle, that's 360 degrees. And the distance around is, of course, the circumference. But if we just think about this little piece of the pie that we were looking at for the angular size, the angle is the angular size. And then the sort of distance here, then, that would be the actual size. And so this relationship that we see up here, this, is going to actually come from here with just some rearranging. But I want to do a little bit more work here. The 360 degrees. Now, the circumference, remember how we find the circumference of a circle? It's 2 pi r. Now, r is the radius in our picture. The radius actually corresponds to the distance. And then we just have the angular size over the actual size. And so I think I'm going to have to go to the next page. So we have the 360 degrees. Over 2 pi times the distance equals the angular size over the actual size. And so let's rearrange this so that we can get back to the expression we were looking to figure, to sort of derive, if you will. The angular size, we're going to make that all by itself. We have 360 degrees. We're going to put that over the 2 pi. And then we're just going to have the actual size over the distance. And guess what? This is 57.3 degrees. And that's where that number comes from. And I think when you see it like that, it makes perfect sense, hopefully.